Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. This healing, this healing, this healing day. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. Thank you for my friends, Spirit. Thank you for my friends. My wonderful, my wonderful, my wonderful friends. My wonderful.
Thank you for this day, Spirit. Thank you for this day. And thank you for joining us here for our live hybrid Sunday service at Unity Spiritual Center in San Francisco. There's a small group of us gathered here at Unity Spiritual Center, and the rest of you are on Zoom. Now, whether you're a regular or joining us for the first time, I'm glad that you found us and pray that you will be nourished during your time here today. One thing to note before we get started, all of you on Zoom are being put on mute during our service so that you don't have to worry about background noise. What that means is for the responsive readings and the songs, we will not hear your voice, but encourage you to say or sing the words along in the privacy of your own home. Now, there are two exceptions to the mute rule. One is the reading of the daily word. I'll be asking for a volunteer to read the daily word today. And if you would like to do that, but don't have a copy of it with you at home, go now to www.dailyword.org, where you'll be able to copy and paste today's reading. Then during the service, when I ask who would like to read it, just raise your hand and I will call on you to do that reading. The other time you can participate is during our prayer time. Again, if you have a prayer request, just raise your hand so that you can speak it at that time. But for now, just take a deep breath wherever you are. As we go within our inner sanctuary, where we are always safe, guided, and at peace, just take this time to let go of any worries or concerns and connect virtually with all of us in this community and with the God of your understanding. Here at Unity Spiritual Center, we celebrate the truth that our God is love, as expressed in Unity's foundation statement, which you are invited to repeat after me at home. There is only one presence and one power, active as the universe and as my life, God the good, omnipotent. So take another deep breath now and become comfortable. Gently release any cares of the day. The only thing you need to do in this hour is to open yourself up to the love and goodness of the divine as you relax into this sacred time and space at Unity Spiritual Center. For 75 years now, we at Unity Spiritual Center have celebrated and honored people of every culture, of every creed, of every religion, of every race, of every age, and every lifestyle, knowing there are many paths to God, many faces of God, many names for God, but only one God. Seeing through the eyes of oneness and acknowledging our oneness, we know that God indwells all people and is expressed through each of us in unique, special, and individual ways. Unity offers positive, practical, progressive spiritual teachings and tools that honor the universal truth in all religions and respects every individual's right to choose a spiritual path. Sorry for that noise. And now, and as you look at the flame of this candle that we light every week, remember that yourself carry a divine flame within and as an individualized expression of God, and that God does God's work in the world through your hands and movements of the heart. Our vision here at Unity Spiritual Center and the opportunity for you and for each one of us here is that you will discover the power within you to create the life of your dreams, that you will have peace of mind and deep happiness, that you enjoy joyous and loving relationships with yourself, with spirit, and with others, that you spend your days doing what you love and feel called to do, and most of all, that you know your life matters, that you make a difference, and that the world is a better place because you're here. Now let us pause for a moment to listen to hear a musical selection sung by USC's own music director, Maestro Michael Hatfield, in his own bow tie.
How could anyone ever tell you you are anything less than beautiful? How could anyone ever tell you you were less than whole? How could anyone fail to notice that your loving is a miracle? And how deeply you're connected to my soul? How could anyone ever tell you you are anything less than beautiful? How could anyone ever tell you you were less than whole? How could anyone fail to notice that your loving is a miracle? How deeply you're connected to my soul. Could anyone ever tell you you were less than whole? How could anyone fail to notice that your loving is a miracle? How deeply you're connected to my soul. How deeply you're connected to my soul.
Thank you, Michael.
You're welcome.
And now, as we continue to get comfortable, relaxing even more deeply into this time of worship, prayer, and meditation, let us open our hearts to receive the message of today's daily word. And if I have a volunteer, I'm scrolling through here. Kira? Okay, thank you. Kira, I'll put you on spotlight.
Am I on spotlight?
There you go.
Okay. Freedom. In thought, word, and action, I celebrate my freedom. There are many ways to feel free. I may work hard to become financially free. I may plan trips so I can freely explore the world. I may commit to learning from intellectual freedom or exercise my body for greater freedom or of movement. Even as I do my work in the world to know freedom, I remember that I am always free at the level of spirit. No situation or circumstance has power over me. Every day and in every area of my life, I live from my divine nature, where I am wholly and completely free. Through my inner powers of understanding and faith, I recognize and embrace empowering beliefs. My spiritual gifts of strength and release keep me on course and help me free myself from habits that derail my spiritual growth. Through God within, I am grateful to be free. From Galatians 5:1, for freedom Christ has set us free.
Thank you, Kira. Unity Spiritual Center is a center of prayer and healing. During this time of shelter in place, you are always welcome to call in, send, or email a prayer request. So please take a moment right now to hold all the written and unwritten prayer requests of our community in your hearts, and know with me that divine love is enfolding each person, and that despite outward appearances, divine order is taking place for all concerned. And now is the time to make our prayers audible, to share our prayer needs to your spiritual family here so that we can support you and stand with you. If you have a particular prayer request, please raise your hand in front of your camera and you will be unmuted, or you can put it in the chat and I will read it. Let us connect our hearts in prayer as Michael plays the music we use for our prayer request time.
We are connected by the heart. Where do you end? Where do I start? Whatever you feel, I feel too. You're a part of me, I'm a part of you. Your prayer is my prayer to your prayer is my prayer to
in the chat. I see prayers, one from Lauren, a prayer request for an upset stomach and low energy and fatigue for him.
Your prayer is my prayer too.
From Kathy Quigley, a prayer for her daughter Lisa, who is flying in from Austin this week. The first time she has seen her in a year, safe and easy flight and a wonderful connection and relationship there, Kathy.
Your prayer is my prayer too.
Prayers from Randy Swindle for healing for her friend Coleman and his family and friends. He made his graceful and peaceful transition yesterday.
Your prayer is my prayer too.
From Jerry McGovern, a prayer request for dear Sini Haney, who left us at the tender age of 20. Prayers for his parents and family.
Your prayer is my prayer too.
And Helen asked for prayers for her husband.
Your prayer is my prayer too.
Now I will scroll through. If you have a prayer request, please raise your hand. I can only see four of you at one time, so be patient. Don't see any raised hands, but another prayer request has come in through the chat, I see. From Karen, may the U.S. be united in peace, respect, and collaboration with one another for the greatest good of all beings and the earth we share. Amen.
Your prayer is my prayer.
Do every Sunday, let us also remember what we're grateful for, beginning now to reflect on those things that are going right in your life, those things that are good, true, and beautiful. And if you'd like to share them with us, raise your hand or put them in the chat.
I'm raising my hand. I'm very thankful for the last week where my whole family got together, including my 99-year-old mother who beat everybody at bridge and skip bow.
Excellent. Other blessings today?
I just want to say I'm grateful I'm able to play beach volleyball again. You know, that's a minor miracle in my life, believe it or not. Thanks.
My brother Alan is thankful to have celebrated birthdays for two of his grandchildren. Those would be my great nephews and nieces. I have them. And from Susan, she is thankful that her daughter arrived here last night from Maryland to spend the week with her. Juanita.
Yes, I'm so grateful and thankful for all the love that was expressed to me yesterday on my birthday with family and friends all over the USA. I am so blessed. All their love and appreciation. Thank you.
And a happy birthday, Juanita. I'm scrolling through. from Jerry McGovern, grateful that her family members are able to bring older, frail family members to celebrate together. And I'm understanding that my voice is soft, so I am getting as close to the mic as I can.
And that will work. So why don't we sing, Jerry?
Okay.
Here we go.
I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed.
We give thanks for this opportunity to bless and be blessed in spirit. We give thanks for the knowledge that when we ask, it will be given to us. When we seek, we will find. When we knock, the door will be opened to us. We give thanks for the feelings of peace and comfort that fill our hearts and minds right now. We give thanks for the privilege of praying for others in our community, in our nation, and around the globe. We affirm that always and in all ways, no matter what appearances may be, divine love and divine order is everywhere present. And so it is. Amen.
Okay, I'm about to play a song that I think everybody can sing along with. There's some nice high notes. You can help me out there on the high notes. And off we go to the races. This is a tune by the Beatles.
Help, I need somebody. Help, not just anybody. Help, you know I need someone. Help. Younger, so much younger than today. I never needed anybody's help in any way. But now those days are gone and I'm not so self-assured. Now I find I changed my mind. I opened up the doors. Help me if you can. I'm feeling down. And I do appreciate your being around. So many ways my independence seems to vanish in the haze, but every now and then I feel so insecure. I know that I just need you like I never done before. Help me if you can. I'm feeling down and I do appreciate you being around. Oh, help me get my feet back on the ground. So younger, so much younger than today. I never needed anybody's help in any way. But now those days are gone and I'm not so self-assured. Now I finally changed my mind. Open up the door. Help me if you can. I'm feeling down and I do appreciate you being around. And help me get my feet back on the ground.
Thank you.
Thank you, Michael.
The audience is roaring in here.
And you don't need any help.
No.
You've got it.
I have all the help I need the last couple of days. It's been great.
We are, of course, today celebrating Independence Day, the 4th of July. It's a day, besides being my husband's birthday, but it's a day when we recall that our nation was founded out of an independence movement. Of course, for most of us, our consciousnesses have been raised to realize that independence did not mean independence for all. It was mostly for white male property owners of the time, of the late 1700s. Black slaves, indigenous peoples, women, those with little or nothing to their names, all fell outside the realm of independence. So it is today that I want to focus instead on interdependence. How do we relate to each other in a way that relies on each other rather than separates ourselves from one another? In our relationships, we can be independent of others, dependent of others, codependent, but the best way is to be interdependent, I think. If we are completely independent, which I'm not sure anybody can actually achieve, we claim we don't need anyone else in our life to get along. We're fine just by ourselves, thank you very much. We may think we're independent, but no one is completely so. We need others, store clerks, bus drivers, and so on. True personal independence doesn't truly exist, I would say. If we're dependent, though, we can't function unless there is another. We rely on others to help us get through life. We need to be in relationship for even the smallest parts of life. And codependence is, as Psychology Today puts it, when someone puts aside their own well-being to maintain a relationship with others. Codependence, of course, leads to a quashing of one's own needs and wants in order to please or stay with another person. Codependence leads to encouraging addictions and all sorts of bad relationship matters. And then there's interdependence, which, as I said, is what I think we should aim for. It is relying on others without over-reliance. It is providing support and assistance when it's called for without sacrificing one's own life. Those in interdependent relationships don't compromise their values on behalf of another. There is balance in the relationship in which each person gives and gains. Achieving and maintaining an independent relationship isn't always easy. It does take work on both sides. There needs to be constant and consistent recognition of the needs and of others and yourself. It takes adjustments and a give and take attitude. Decisions and actions need to be good for both parties. It takes a willingness to step outside of stubbornness and obstinacy to come to compromise. Interdependence requires awareness on both sides. How do my actions, desires, and wants affect another person? Am I asking too much? Am I asking so much that the person is left without their own fulfillment and joy? Sometimes interdependence does require compromise. We'll do something my way this time, and next time we do it your way. An interdependent relationship does not mean we always get what we want. Sometimes we have to forgo our own desires for the good of relationship, but that doesn't mean we ignore or dispose of our desires. We recognize them and realize that they may need to be fulfilled at another point in the relationship. So far, I have talked about interdependence in a two-person relationship, how two people interact and deal with each other. But what about the bigger picture? Can there be interdependence on a group setting? Can more than two people be interdependent? Well, I would say that yes, a group can practice interdependence. In fact, I'd say it's important that groups practice interdependence. We form communities and rely on each other for needs and wants. We might want to give a little for the group, but we don't want to subsume our own identities for the sake of the group. We remain individuals within the community. Think of a community to which you belong. It can be a small group or larger. It can be your neighborhood or the city you live in or an association you belong to, such as AA. It can be something along the lines of the LGBT community, or it can be this congregation. How do you interact with that group? Do you give to it as well as receive from it? Do you feel it takes from you without returning anything? Or do you feel an equality amongst its members, including yourself? To be interdependent, a community must recognize the individuality of each member while keeping the goals and aims of the group alive. It needs to affirm the worth of each and every member and recognize the contributions of each. Those goals and aims need to be agreed upon by everyone so that there is a purpose to the community. Decisions are often by consensus. The broader the group, though, the more difficult this becomes. We can sit down as a congregation and decide on a direction and hope for future with a fair amount of ease. But on the other hand, to get a whole nation to agree to some goals is much more difficult, as it is even for a political party, say. Interdependence is trickier the larger the community. For too long, we have discounted the voices of marginalized people in our society. We have not practiced interdependence to its fullest. Since the founding of this nation to today, some voices have outweighed the voices of those who have less power, less presence in the community. We have shut out those who don't fit the white, straight, male picture at times. Our interdependence has been lacking, and if we are to celebrate our need for each other, we need to find ways to include all voices. Yes, this is Independence Day. So celebrate and enjoy the company of friends and family. Have a picnic, walk on the beach, go to see fireworks. Whatever it is that helps you remember that you are a part of the community of this nation. But recognize that our independence is not truly independence. We are interdependent on each other and need to allow all to have a voice and express their hopes, desires, needs, and wants. So be it. Amen. So now I invite you, wherever you are, to sit back, relax, make yourself comfortable. I invite you to close your eyes if you're comfortable doing that. Now focus on your breathing. Feel the air flowing in and out of your nostrils. In and out. In and out. Feel your chest rising and falling with each breath. Rising and falling. Rising and falling. Rising and falling. Breathing in light and goodness and love, breathing out any tension or worry or thoughts that are getting in the way of your being present this moment, right here, right now. Breathing in light, breathing out tension, breathing in love. Breathing out distracting thoughts. Now you are more relaxed. And in your imagination, find yourself walking outdoors somewhere, beautiful and safe and precious to you. You find yourself walking towards a building that has sweet memories for you. It might be the house where you grew up. It might be the house you live in now, or the house of a beloved grandparent, or another building or home or place that is special to you, where you felt or feel absolutely safe and loved. See yourself walking into this place of love and goodness. You find yourself in a large room, a large space, huge really. In this building, you find yourself in this huge room, standing in the center of it. Notice the color of the walls, the floors. What furniture is there and what is it like? Notice any sounds in this room. Can you hear the beating of your own heart? Notice how you are feeling inside. Soon, as you stand in the center of this room, you will notice that others are entering the room. Slowly, they are coming in to join you. They are forming a large circle all around you. This is your blessed community circle. In this circle are all the sentient beings who form your true community. Take a look around you now as they continue to enter and form a very large, wide circle all around you. Who is here with you today? See their faces. Feel how wonderful it is to have them all in the same space with you, all of them. Notice there are people here from your past. People who have died and passed on to the other side. People who are part of your life now. Animals and pets who have loved you unconditionally, both past and present. And notice too, as you look around, that there are people here whom you have never met. People you are drawn to. People who have touched your life through art or words or religion or politics or dance. All of these people are your own blessed community. You have come here together today to celebrate you. Now, still standing in the center of your sacred circle, just imagine that each person and animal who is there is shining its precious, beautiful light onto you, in the center, all at once. And turning slowly around so you can look into the eyes of each and every one. Just savor the feeling of love and light that washes over you as you do this. And also, if you choose, imagine a greater divine love shining down on all of you from above and filling you with a feeling of safety and of being love. Now, if you want, ask your circle if one or more of your community has a message for you right now in your life today. Invite one or more of your community to join you in the center. Listen to the message that this being has to give to you today. It's time to start thinking about coming back to the present moment now. But first, say goodbye to your blessed community circle and remind yourself that you will be back very, very soon. You can be here in this loving space, connected with your community anytime, anywhere. It's just a matter of seconds, a matter of focused awareness. Then, when you are ready, slowly and mindfully leave your circle. finding your way back through the building the same way you came in, walking slowly and carefully back down the sacred path. Mindful of your breath moving in and out of your nose, mindful of the love that you are bringing back with you, love and a new sense of connectedness to your own blessed community. And then in your own time and your own way, come back to the room you are in. Feel your feet on the floor, your legs, your back against the chair or whatever you are sitting on. Feel your shoulders, your neck, your head. Again, feel your breath as it enters through your nose and mouth, shimmers through your body, and then exits. And then in your own time, open your eyes. There is no rush. Take your time. All is well. Sorry, I knocked things off of my iPad. Okay, I'm back to it. Here at Unity Spiritual Center, join me. We are an ocean of love. Here at Unity Spiritual Center, we have an inspiring vision, an exciting mission, and compelling values by which we strive to live. Our vision is, say it with me, centered in God, we co-create a world powerfully transformed through the growing movement of shared spiritual awakening. Our mission is, we are a creative, joy-filled, spiritual community dedicated to healing, inspiring, and transforming the lives of all people through prayer, education, and love. And our values are, we are spirit-led, generous with resources, inclusive, joyously creative, and guided by integrity. And feeling inspired by our vision, mission, and values, and feeling so enriched by what we've experienced here today and will continue to experience through our gathering time following the service, let us take time now to be a channel for enrichment through generous tithes and love offerings. As Michael shares yet another beautiful song, please take the time to write out a check to USC or log on to our website at www.unitysf.org to make a donation online. Please remember that our expenses do continue through this time as we look for ways to stay connected with you. Let us now take a moment to bless our tithes and love offerings, cupped in our hands or next to our hearts, as we say together our offering prayer. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, God.
We will find a way, although it's not in front of us. If we keep looking, it will be there. find a way. Surely it's surrounding us. Together we will discover way. One can start the motion and put the plan in play. We can all live together to get us through the day. Strength is found in numbers and cannot be ignored. We'll learn the truth and it will be restored. For we will find a way, although it's not in front of us. If we keep on looking, it will be there. We will find a way, and surely it's surrounding us. Together, we will discover where. Build the future, a vision we will frame. We cannot fail to make it, there is only us to blame. Call upon your neighbors, reach out to your friends. We'll heal your disagreements, begin to make amends. For we will find a way, although it's not in front of us. If we keep on looking, it will be there. Find a way, surely it's surrounding us. Together we will discover where. Many times this lesson has been taught and then forgot. It must be reread the chapter and understand the plot. Love is the beginning and peace will be the end, and the story shall continue as we try to comprehend. That we will find a way, although it's not in front of us. If we keep on looking, it will be there. We will find a way, and surely it's surrounding us. Together we will discover where.
Thank you again, Michael.
You're welcome.
Beautiful. So now let us bless our offerings with the prayer that will be on your screen shortly. Please join me in our blessing. Spirit of the living God, bless the acts of our hands, our minds, our hearts. May everything offered here at Unity Spiritual Center be a reflection of all that is good within us. Grant us the courage to patiently listen for the stirring of your presence. Enliven our spirits with humor. Fill us with reverence for one another and gratitude for our diversity. May unity, beauty, and truth be the fruit of all we do, and so it is. Amen. We come to our time for announcements, and I invite you to stick around afterwards. We're going to try to have a hospitality time. We'll see how that works with us here. But don't forget, the Daily Word guided meditation is every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon, except there is no guided meditation tomorrow. So don't try to sign on Zoom tomorrow, Monday the 5th, because of the holiday. And also don't forget, a week from today, July 11th, we will be reopening for in-person services. So we've had these times of dress rehearsals, and next week we're gonna go live.
Yeah, for real.
For real. So join us. Also this week on Wednesday, you are invited to join in with the book group that has been meeting to meet the author Greg Lavoie. That is at 4 o'clock on Wednesday the 7th. And it will be it was a very interesting book, and I'm sure it'll be an interesting time meeting the author. So feel free to join us, even if you haven't been part of the book group. Now, I've got to see if there are children here. I don't see Annette or Reuben or Josephine. So I'm assuming not, but let us take a moment to bless them wherever they are, hopefully having a good time.
Yes.
Let us bless our children. We love you. We bless you. We appreciate you. And we behold the presence of God in you, empowering you to do great things.
And you can now tell them that I get to play again.
Oh, yes. Now we pay attention to Michael again because he's going to play the peace song.
Exactly that.
That was meant to be with God as creator. Family, all are we. Let me walk with my family in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. I take, let this be my joyous vow, to take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
Indeed. So go into this week knowing you are interdependent, knowing that others rely on you, knowing that you rely on others. And let us go into this day and the coming week knowing that the light of God surrounds us, the love of God enfolds us, the power of God protects us, the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. Wherever I am, God is. And all is well. Thank you.
There will be a little intermission music. We're just figuring out what that's going to be. And I think I'm going to just have some fun is what I think I'm going to do. So give me a moment while I fix a few things on my little machine over here. Go ahead and break into small discussion groups. Okay, we're just going to play anyways. That's how that goes.
Go for it.
You know what? Roger Miller, it makes sense to me, so we're all going to sing along with Roger Miller. Why not?
Trailers fall to sail or rent. Room to let 50 cent. No phone, no pool, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes. So but 2 hours of pushing broom buys them 8x12 4-bedroom. Mama, man of means by no means, king of the road.
destination, Bangor, Maine. Old worn out shirt and shoes, I don't pay no union dues. I smoke old stogies, I have fun. Short, but not too big around. I'm a man of means by no means. King of the road, I know every engineer on every train. All of their children and all of their names. Every handout in every town. And every lock that ain't locked when no one's around to sing. Trailers fall, say low rent. Room to let 50 cent. No phone, no pool, no pets. Ain't got no cigarettes. So but 2 hours of pushing broom buys them 8 by 12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means by no means. King of the road, well, I'm a man of means by no means. King of the road, well, I'm a man of means by no means. And I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy, king of the road.
There's a cowbell. Yeah.
Cowbell.
Okay. You can stop sharing your screen, and actually, if you want to, we can turn off the system once we start the conversation. You can just go with your headphones or your earbuds, or just you're far enough away they can continue on. So we'll give it a try right now.
So keep on keeping on. I'll sign off the other computers.
Okay, and I will turn off the spotlight if I can figure that out.
Can y'all hear us now?
That's because our computer's skewing back Zoom.
Yeah.
Can he hear?
You're hearing us?
Yes.
Excellent.
Yeah, yay. I hear you, Jerry.
Yay.
First time you've listened to me in years.
No, there was one other time.
So, what's on our minds for today?
Hi, is Michael still there?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Michael, I want you to feel jealous because yesterday I celebrated with probably a friend of yours, Elvin Bishop, band up at Lucas Valley. It was a blast.
I love
it. Was a blast with the Blues Broads. It was great.
Excellent.
Yes. Thank
Sounds
you.
Like you were celebrating well, Juanita.
Yes, up in the hills, looking the ocean. It was fabulous.
Wonderful. Do others have plans for today? Any celebration plans?
Not a thing.
Not a thing.
Just joyous that it came through the year.
That's right.
It's time to rest, recharge.
Yes, it is.
Time to recharge.
Oh, yes.
So blessed.
So no big plans, no picnics, no gatherings. Okay.
No, it's a little too cloudy here.
Too cloudy?
Yeah.
I think it is here too. I can't see outside.
I can see.
So what, any great memories of 4th of July in the past?
Oh, I have one. My aunt and uncle had a beachfront house. And many years ago, we had a sort of a family gathering there, another uncle and his wife. And my parents and I went down to this house for the 4th. and the house next door to them was being used as a rental at the time. So the evening came and people shoot their fireworks off at the beach, which is, you know, considered fairly safe. Well, the folks next door had some fireworks that I had never seen before. I mean, they were unbelievable fireworks. I mean, you just don't see things like that on the beach or anywhere. So finally the police came. Well, they were industrial, actually military level fireworks. They're used for lighting the night sky when they're doing battles and things. and that's what we saw. It was quite a show.
I guess so. That's a great memory. And how old were you?
Oh, I was a young adult.
Oh, okay.
It was a long time ago, Jerry.
Oh, not that long. I didn't know whether you were a little kid or grown up or what. Any others? I remember I used to, when I lived in Boston, go down to the Hatch Shell where the Boston Pops Orchestra played a 4th of July concert and would sit on the grass. And you got there early and put out your blanket so you'd have your space. And all your friends would come. And they ended up playing the 1812 Overture at the end and shooting off fireworks. Awesome. That was always a good time. Mm-hmm. What else is on people's minds? I don't usually get to stay for these times. So I don't know what you all talk about.
Usually,
mostly we talk about you, Jerry.
Is that why my ears ring?
I'm looking forward to next week. I know it's the 4th and it's a holiday and everything, but I was thinking this morning, oh, I've got to get up earlier next week. I don't want to be late.
Yes. You have to get used to that getting in the car and getting there thing.
Well, I'm lucky I can walk, but you know.
Still. Okay. Still, you have to get yourself here.
That's right.